Do you know why before and after pseudo elements don't work with the isFunctional pseudo class? Do you know what is the difference between HSL color format and OKLCH color format? And most importantly, do you know why you're not writing as much code as you'd like to at your work and why that is perfectly okay? Find out all about this and more in the next few minutes. This episode is sponsored by View School. More on how you can access all of their courses completely for free in a bit. First up, the Mania Fifth explains why before and after pseudo elements don't work with the isFunctional pseudo class. The isPseudo class allows you to shorten complex selectors. For example, this one, container button large, container button small, can be shortened with the isFunctional pseudo class exactly like this. Here we're selecting all buttons within a container that have a class large or small. It might not be intuitive, but it doesn't work if you add pseudo elements right here. As Temani explains, the is works in a way that adds a condition to the selection, just like other selectors as IDs, classes, and more. And if you want to understand exactly why this doesn't work, all you need to do is read those selectors out loud. Let's read this selector, button is small large. Select any element that is a button and match the selectors inside is that have class small or class large. In the same principle, you could read out this selector, select any element that is a button and match the selectors inside is. This essentially means that we are selecting this element, button, and we are narrowing it down with selectors inside before and after, and since those are pseudo elements, that means that we cannot match a button element that is simultaneously a before pseudo element. This is probably one of the nicest explanations about why pseudo elements don't work with the isFunctional pseudo class. Read the Temani's article to get more details and check out his website CSS Tip, where he shares a ton of tips on CSS. Next up, Andrei Sitnik gives a fantastic introduction to OKLCH color format and why you should switch to it immediately. If you don't understand exactly how it works or why you should switch to it, then this is the article that you have to read. The extremely short version is precisely this. L is perceived lightness from 0 to 1, and perceived means that it has consistent lightness for your eyes, unlike lightness in HSL color format. C stands for chroma, which goes from gray to most saturated color, or actually it is equivalent to saturation in HSL color format. And lastly, we have H, which is hue angle, which is again pretty much the same as H in HSL color format. But if that's the case, then what is the difference between OKLCH and HSL color formats? OKLCH has a number of benefits, and I'll single out most important ones in my opinion here. For one, it supports wide gamut P3 colors, and this means that this color format supports all colors that are available on newer devices that come with better screens, meaning that with this color format, you can actually display those colors while the other older color formats, such as HSL, don't actually support all of the colors available in those high-end screens. Another advantage to HSL specifically is that it uses perceptual lightness, so you won't get unexpected results with OKLCH like you can get with HSL. And this is a little bit more complicated to explain, so you're going to have to read the article yourself, but it's pretty clearly visualized in this graphic right here. So this is what HSL looks like, and this is OKLCH. Even though OKLCH seems deformed, HSL is actually the one that is deformed. And you can clearly see this if you examine this graphic right here, because you see that the gray comes way up right here, which means it's not uniform. So if you create a gradient that goes from here to here, you can get pretty unexpected results, while this cannot happen with the OKLCH color format. I'm going to say it again, read the article, it's really good, and you will learn exactly why you should switch to OKLCH color format today, and what are the advantages to other color formats, not just HSL, but also to hex and more. This episode is sponsored by View School. View School should be your go-to resource to learn everything about the Vue framework. They offer a ton of fantastic courses that will help you master Vue, and for a limited time, you can get access to all of their courses completely for free. So regardless if you have experience with Vue or if you're a pure beginner, use this opportunity to access all of their lessons, more than 1500, completely for free. All you have to do is sign up with your email to reserve your spot. I'm going to do it right now because I definitely want to jump on this deal. info@cssweekly.com, I will reserve my spot, and not only will I get all of those lessons for free, I can get early Black Friday deals, such as 60% off for their yearly or lifetime subscription. If you want to learn more about Vue, this is your chance. Don't miss it out. Sign up today. Thanks so much to Vue School for sponsoring. Next up, Dave Rupert will tell you why you can't drink coffee on a running horse. This is actually a slug for this article, and I don't know where that comes from, but I absolutely love it. In any case, in this article, Dave gives a nice overview of what goes into a day-to-day work of a typical web developer. So you're not only writing code, you are checking emails, scheduling calls, writing release notes, making spreadsheets, clarifying decisions, reviewing PRs, attending talks, learning, planning, dreaming, scheming, community ops. There's a ton of stuff that you are doing here. And this list is just a nice reminder that if at the end of the day, you look at your output and you see that you really didn't write that much code, that is perfectly okay and perfectly normal. You don't have to feel bad about it because our work is much more than just purely writing code. And this is even more important to understand today when we can get AI to write a ton of code for us. Our job is much more complex, much more nuanced than just typing code. So if you're trying to advance your career, learning to write better, more usable, more efficient code is not enough. You're going to have to master all of those things right here if you actually want to become a better web developer. Next up, we have a nice CSS snippet by Will Mendes. This snippet will help you highlight accessibility errors in your HTML and CSS, such as missing alt text, improperly structured unordered and ordered lists, and more. So let's try it out on a random website. I'm going to copy the CSS. I will open CSS Stickers website. By the way, if you still don't have a CSS Stickers pack, get one right now. Not only will your laptop look much better, but you'll actually support your favorite newsletter and YouTube channel, CSS Weekly. Thanks so much. Let's open Developer Tools here. I'm going to go into Sources panel, select my CSS file, and I'll just paste this snippet at the end of the file. There we go. Save. It doesn't seem like I have any errors, but let's break something so we can see exactly what this looks like. I'm going to remove the alt text on this image. As you see, the snippet is working, and this image is clearly not accessible because it doesn't have a proper alternative text anymore. So use the snippet either in developer tools like I've shown you, or better yet, add it into your project directly. And if you, in the course of development, make an accessibility mistake, it will be painfully obvious that you made one, just like it is right here. Last up, we have a stunning demo by Ben Evans. This is a full 3D CSS game. I'm going to expand the JavaScript panel here so you can be certain that there's absolutely no JavaScript here whatsoever. This game is created purely in CSS. It looks absolutely amazing. I'm not going to go into the code. I don't think I have the skills to understand this. This is absolutely amazing. There is more than 13,000 lines of CSS here, which shows you that the work that went into this is absolutely astonishing. Let's enter the demo. I can use arrows on the screen to move around this 3D environment. It's mind-blowing that this was created only with CSS. I hope this demo inspires you to create something incredible, because CSS these days really is fantastic. Don't just default to Tailwind. Try out new CSS features. You'll definitely won't be sorry. And you might even be able to create something stunning as this demo by Ben Evans. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different CSS 3D game. Or rather, in the next video.